I am totally against corruption. We are against corruption, but the way this government targets some, particularly some people, threatening the voice of the opposition, that is bad, for which unity is needed. So that kind of, such kind of unity is need of the hour, for which I hope this forum will help. And once again, on behalf of All India Insurance Employers Association, I wholeheartedly support and greet you on this happy occasion. Thank you, comrade.
S. Venkatapati from railway sector.
Good afternoon to everybody. On behalf of railway, I give salute to all the dignitaries of the dais and on the dais. First, we want to thank the person who made the idea of bringing all the association and private public sector under in one roof. First, we want to thank him and thank for the organizing association for making the elaborate arrangements to conduct this first conference at Chennai and bring the gatherings from all over India. And this gives a very good warning bell to the policy makers that all the hands are joined together and it will grow further. And this is the first warning bell given to them. And government is elected by the public not to show any profit or loss account. It is for the public to serve better. That they forgot, and they are only making profit, profit, profit in everything. So this is the warning we have to give from our side to the our policy makers. Thank you very much.
Now I request comrade H.M. Mallesh. He is from defense PSU BEML. There are 10 defense PSUs, 9 defense PSUs. Comrade Anil Kumar and comrade Lakshmi Narayan, please come on the dais. Lakshmi Narayan.
Good evening, friends. Respected NCOA President Tomar Ji, Secretary General Baby Thomas Ji, and SBOA Chief Mr. Franco Ji, and all my colleagues on the dais, and my all you dear friends. See, now it is the time to speak on strategic industries, that is defense industries, where government since independence or Britishers have opened these industries, many of these industries, for the security and sovereignty at that time for their purpose, and later on Indian government has boosted a momentum to that. And this today 9 defense PSUs are there. Just I will make a in 3 minutes bird view of what is defense sector and how many are there, what they are doing. Because bank means we will go, no, bank money they are handling, deposits they are handling, like that. Defense public sectors, you mean to say lot of money will come from government, these people enjoying and going home, that is the public perception. It is not so. Today, every order is competitive, every venture is competitive. If we quickly look at the performance of defense PSUs, all the defense PSUs, 9 defense PSUs are continuously making profit. So, 1/3 of the defense business, what defense ministry allocating funds, 1,75,000, 2 lakh crores, to the extent of 40,000 to 45,000 crores are from defense PSUs. Under that, Hindustan Aeronautics are there all over the country, Bharat Electronics, BEL, what you call, BDL, Bharat Dynamics Limited, Hyderabad, BEML Limited, Bangalore, Mazagon Dock Shipbuilders at Mumbai, Garden Ridge Shipbuilders Engineers, GRSE, what we call, that is in Calcutta, Mishra Dhatu Nigam is in Hyderabad, Goa Shipyard is in Goa, Hindustan Shipyard at Vizag. See, if we take 2015-16, 41,000 crores, 41,070 crores business they have made, and profit after tax 4,600 crores. Almost 10% average, all the PSUs are making 10% profit with this competitive environment. If you look at quickly what HAL will do, HAL is a 75-year-old company. After existence, it has opened in 1938 by Walchand Hirachand. Later British government has taken over, then handed over to Government of India in 1947. That what you call, you can son or daughter of Bemmel is HAL is the father, because 1964 the coach factory and car body, what they were making HAL, separated as a Bharat Earthmoors Limited in 1964. We are also part of HAL before 1964. Then Bemmel has grown further. I will tell you when it comes to Bemmel. It is a Navaratna company. It is having a 20 production divisions, 11 R&D centers spread all over the country. So far they have produced indigenously 15 types of aircraft, 14 types under license. So recently, in the last 2 years, they have developed a core engine for turbofan engines, then structural repair shop for Sukhoi 30 aircrafts, then orbiter craft module structure for ISRO satellite center they have made, and they are opening helicopter manufacturing division at Tumkur, 70 kilometers away from Bangalore, and they have received a lot of awards. So all PSUs they are receiving every year awards. Then if you come to BEL is a Navaratna company that is also established in 1954. We can say under Defence Ministry it is a total systemized company. Bharat Electronics means we think that they will do electronics, not exactly electronics. Defense electronics are much complicated. Night vision cameras, radar systems, electro-optics, and military tanks, electro-optics for military tanks, and electronic voting machines, PCs, ICs, hybrid circuits, lot of, they are into electronic hardcore industry for the defense. They are into much self-reliance. They are having a robust R&D plan. They will spend around 8% of their turnover towards R&D. Normally companies will provide 2-3%. They are spending 8%. So their recent achievements are, they have developed surface to air Akash missile system, and they have handed over to IAF, Indian Air Force. Then 80% of the turnover is come from indigenized products. Then continuously modernization programs they are having, and they are also into Anandpur district. They are opening a missile related components factory. Foundation stone has been laid. So Bharat Dynamics at BDL, it is opened in 1970, and Miniratna category 1 company, and they are into anti-tank guided missiles. Now missiles, what we speak, QRSAM missiles, surface-to-air missiles, surface-to-surface missiles, they are into missile business. They are also expanding their units at Amravati, Maharashtra, and in Telangana district also. They are integrated to medium-range surface-to-air missile systems, and they are also achieved indigenization in the missiles to the extent of 71-90%. Bemmel Limited, so I am from Bemmel, it is our own company. So I have told it is established in 1964, separated from HAL. Later it has been expanded its activities in Kolar gold fields for earth moving equipments. In Mysore we are having 2 factories, 1 engine and truck manufacturing factory. In 2007 it expanded its business in Tatra truck for defense supplies at Palakkad complex, Kerala. And what Bemmel will do, and we are into metro coaches also. Bangalore unit completely dedicated to metro coaches. We have supplied to Delhi metro, Bangalore metro, Kolkata metro, this. Then coming to defense system of BML, we are making heavy duty trucks, Tata trucks, what we call, to carry jawans, army soldiers, their arms, ammunition, mounting vehicles to BEL, BDL, Bharat Electronics and BDL, what are the products they develop, they want mounting vehicles to hand over to defense. So those vehicles also we are doing. T-series battle tanks, T-72, T-90, what the tanks now they are using in the borders. So those tanks we are using, manufacturing. Then transmissions for battle tanks, air cleaner ejector assemblies for battle tanks we are doing. Our indigenization level is average 50%. In certain defense related trucks we have made 90%, average we are at 50%, and we are total business comes from 50% of our R&D products in competitive environment. And BML also received many awards. Then come to Mishra Dhatu Nigam, Midhani, what we call in Hyderabad. It is also a Mini Ratna company established in 1973. They are more into alloys. They are the alloys manufacturers, combination of many material. They have also recently developed 105 grades of high performance alloys for different shapes and sizes. Then they are also into indigenization, and recently they have developed a products Superni 42, Supercast 55. So to mention here, then Mezgandak Shipbuilders, it is in Mumbai. It is a leading shipyard company. They are engaged in manufacturing of warships, submarines. Presently, they are constructing missile destroyers, Scorpion submarines, one of the category. And they are also into R&D initiatives. They have spent around 60 crores last year towards R&D. Then modernization also they have taken up. Their shipbuilding, they are expanding their facility into different yards. And their indigenized percentage is 42% was there last 3 years, before 3 years. Now it is up to 78% they have indigenized. So then Garden Ridge Builders, Kolkata. They are also Mini Ratna category one company. They are presently, they are making 14 warships under construction. Regularly warships they are manufacturing. Anti-submarine welfare corvettes they are doing. Then they are also into modernization. 3 stealth frigates under project 17A they call. They are doing modular shipbuildings. That company also receiving continuously awards one or the other every year. Then Goa Shipyard at Goa, it is also a Mini Ratna Group 1 company. They are designing and building high technology ships for Indian defense, and export also they are doing the ships. Around 1000 crores ships export they have made so far. So last year they have delivered 105M called name. Offshore patrol vessel into coastal guard, and under Make in India initiatives, 12 mine countermeasure vessels they are building. R&D initiatives they have also taken for development and design of their defense requirements, and that company also received many awards year after year. Hindustan Shipyard at Vizag. So they are into shipyards. They have built so far 174 vessels, and they have repaired. They are into repair of ships also. 1940 ships so far they have repaired. So 5 IPVs called Rani Durgavati and others they have produced, and they are having a MOU with a global ship company Hyundai Heavy Industries Company Limited. They are also into R&D for design capabilities. Then around Government of India sanctioned 457 crores long back, 3 years before, and they are also into modernization using that. So far they have spent 110 crores. So regarding this history of these PSUs continuously making profit around 10% growth every year, there also threat of disinvestment and strategic sale, both has come. So government first said it is a policy for self-reliance of Indian Army, and another the name they have given is indigenization, state of the art technology and economically viable. And last 3 years reliance, self-reliance, and what the achievement, our defense minister himself admits, please listen carefully. On the one hand, the entry of private investment, including foreign investment in the sector, has been made smooth and hassle-free. On the other hand, sincere efforts have been made to improve the performance of the capabilities of defense public undertakings and ordnance factories. The government has recently come out with a strategic partnership model to create capacities and capabilities in the private sector over and above the capacities and capabilities already existing in the public sector. How overnight these facilities can be created? Now we have understood that these companies, since over 70 years of time, you have developed at this stage. Today some new entry private partnership in India, he will come and suddenly he will give best of the art best technology, state of the art technology. How is it possible? We have to understand this and realize what is happening. See, in the name of best of the art technology, these people will take an order first, then they will eye on these defense PSUs which I can purchase. For that pre-work we have to do. My friend is having a scooter, he don't want to sell. I want to take that scooter only. What I will do? One of his close friend, I will meet him and send as a messenger. So that is what exactly is happening. So then in 2001, it is open to 100% Indian private sector with 26% limitation. Now in 2016, automatic route up to 49% and with government permission for 100% disinvestment. So far they have issued 342 industrial licenses covering 205 components. 36 FDI foreign direct investments have been rejected. And all government has made all policies, procedures in last March. What should be the partner and what should be financial capacity? Only 1,000 crores they have declared. Any 1,000 crore company can participate in this defense, manufacture of defense. I will take 1 minute. Sir, as far as BML is concerned, in last October 2016, this strategic sale 26% cabinet has cleared. Later you have met industry minister, this defense minister, Mr. Parikarji, along with our Karnataka minister. After hearing, as he has assured, your interest will be protected, he said. But unfortunately, again in February we have met. Immediately after a month, he has left Delhi. And he went as a chief minister of Goa, then later immediately has taken. So once Parikar went out, legal advisors, valuators, transaction advisors have been appointed. Valuation has come into picture. Valuation, the process is in final stages. Still we are resisting. As we know, since 2 months over, so far no issues when valuators have come regarding land and building certain documentation issues, means ownership issues that has arisen. So it is going little slow as on now. So we have to mitigate that issue. We are continuous touch with our Tomar ji, Franco ji, and Baby Thomas ji, and all national leaders are helping. What other ways we can do? And 8th, 9th and 10th there is a dharna at Jantar Mantar in New Delhi. I will request Tomar saab to attend and address the meeting. So thank you very much, sir, for giving this opportunity. Thank you very much for patient hearing.
Now I request comrade Subramani from pharmaceutical sector. I request all the speakers, please take time of the 5 minutes or 6 minutes, because time is very short.
Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. It really gives an immense pleasure to address this very big August assembly with the veterans who are there, who are talking about the very big intricacy of the governmental policies and other things, where several sector we come across several sectors are struggling, or every day they are really, you know, taking a big breath, whether to survive in this, so in a big public sector companies are shut down, whether to run the show or not to run the show. So in this augmented issues, where among the other things, our Karnataka Antibiotics, one of the pharmaceutical company, is also one small company which also comes under the Karnataka Enterprises, Government of India Enterprises. Now, I have been asked by the very senior leaders to talk about the sector as such. When you talk about the whole sector as a pharma, there are several important aspects we need to address. I request to give a presentation on Indian pharma, how the Indian pharma has been augmented here, and how we are very good in the sector. Nevertheless, they tell us to disinvest. The government has come with a policy of disinvest. It has appeared in several newspapers, etc. So now the Indian pharma industry is 2020. Just go back to the previous slide, please. Previous slide. It was a real clear cut. Indian Pharma Vision 2020 by me. Change the slide. Yeah. It is pharmaceutical manufacturing sector is one of the unique where you never come across. You people also spoken about the manufacturing, other public sector industries, including even insurance, other things. The pharma plays a vital role in safeguarding our life. Life is everything. Even the Prime Minister want to survive, we need to give him a life-saving drugs, where he is targeting such a companies which really want to save our India, Indian people, Indian community, Indian society, where there he put a restriction not to disinvest. The minister also in favor of the Prime Minister's version that it has to be disinvested. Very small company making a continuous profit. This is I'll talk about later. Now, next. It's highly fragmented industry. 20,000 registered manufacturers are there in our country. The top 20 companies are contribute 70% of the total turnover of the pharmaceutical products. The total turnover of formulations is about 35,000 crores. Formulation means there is no R&D, there is no research and development. It is only the formulation. Just bring the antibiotic powder, mix it, give it as an injection. This is only the generic form of it, where this itself is very, very big potential we have. Okay, then the fourth largest by volume, but value, we rank much lower. But the largest volume we are having. Okay, India plays a vital role in self-sufficiency. 85% of the formulations and 60% in actives. Actives is active pharma ingredients or raw material, very high costliest items, which has been given to the foreign investments leaders to carry out this business, which is really we having high potential to grab, and India can grow enormously in this particular segment. Okay, largest US FDA approvals units outside India. So USD, they talk about the standards, USD approval, United States pharmacopeial standards, but those US Americans are telling not to buy any medicines from India, but they buy everything indirectly, they buy all the medicines from us only. So it means those people want to buy more medicine from us indirectly, but they refuse to sell directly our products to the America. It means you think about they are degrading our companies and intellectual powers and the brain drain. Okay, next. Next one. The strength of, I've just taken this entire pharma segment into the strength, weakness and opportunity threat analysis. See here, again, strength is knowledge. We have enormous knowledge with us, but all the public sector companies have a potential, but they are not able to tap it. They see that it has been given to a private hands. Next. It is human capital. As far as capital, human capital is concerned, we have massive. We can get the things done at the cheapest rate. Very, very important aspects. So where do we create employment opportunity for ourselves? Then excellent manufacturing facility. India could mine, can bring enormous facility in manufacturing. So the third one is cost efficient. We can produce it at the cheaper cost. That's the reason those people are the health, transparency or the health tourism. When you compare this health tourism is concerned, the people are traveling to get operated their cardiology problem, health problems. All the people travel here to get operated. It means it is very cheap for us. Okay. It is global quality. We have high standard quality of pharma products with us. the India as a whole, the quick response to the opportunity. Any problems we come across as, any crisis which come across as, or any calamities we face as, or anything we come across flood and other things, we are at the forefront. Pharma companies at forefront to resolve the problem, give the medicine instantaneously. A foreign company which opened there cannot give any facility or treatment to our Indian people to survive. It is only the Indian company should do everything. For that, the pharma company plays a role again. Next, the quick, then suitable for Make in India. See, the Modi ji was talking much about Make in India, Make in India. So Make in India is possible within India, provided if he is not bringing any technology. The technology has been taken from us. Most of the brain drain happens. Most of our intellectual people are gone to US and other countries, and they have been paid properly and well. And India, as a being a government, not taken care of our people. And they always talk about disinvestment and how the people can survive here. So they go to other countries where the other countries take them as a very important intellectuals. Next, please. So our weakness, if you talk about it, is very less. See, low healthcare spending. We have created an awareness among the people that we need to spend more on our health. Health awareness has created in a large scale now. Okay. Next, the inadequate infrastructure, where the government is not giving us a sufficient facility. Though we have a higher percentage of stake, but the government is curtailing. They are disinvesting. Then how do you come across this inadequate infrastructure? It is impossible. Next, madam. Fragmentation. It has been subdivided. The government has subdivided our pharmaceutical company not to come in one platform to serve the sufferings. Next, another is non-cooperative policy of the government, which really put us at the very back. Because of the governmental policy, when Tomar was talking about the policy of the government depends. Yeah, the government policy depends upon the company's development, depends upon the policy. If your policy is good, our development will be excellent. If you don't encourage if you don't give us a good policy decisions, definitely we suffer. The public sector will suffer, no doubt about it. I agree with you, sir. It is a very wonderful point you have given. Then non-cooperation with the government. Next, madam. Yeah, the threats. As far as the pharma segment, the total sector of pharma is concerned, we have a Chinese competition. The Chinese people, they have this anti-dumping. Whatever they manufacture, whether it is a qualitative medicines or not, they can simply come and dump it into India at a cheaper rate, where the government policy is encouraging for that. That has to be discontinued, which is very, very objectionable. It cost the life of our sufferings of the people of India. So the protectionism, we need to have a lot of protectionism as far as this threat is concerned. Next. Then the squid focus on priorities. We don't bother. The government has never bothered about giving the priorities. So that is the real problem with Indian pharmaceutical is concerned. Uncertainty of the public sector pharma. Next. It is because government policy. Again, the companies which has been existing, the government never encourages to come up. They always, the ministers will be the pharma ministry, or the ministers always thinking that he want to run his own show along with the FDI. Whatever the foreign direct investment coming into India, you just want to have a hand in glove with them and see that those companies, his own company is run because of huge profit. So where there is no support from us, from the government. Next. Very frequent threat of disinvestment by government, which really made us to suffer a lot. We can't able to move forward, or we cannot able to run our show very properly because of the threat of the disinvestment by the government, where our senior leaders are really concentrating to somehow bring down and dilute it. Next. The opportunity, we have a lot of opportunity to develop a pharma company into a pharma sector into a very big level. One is the aging of the blockbuster model and other economic forces. Next. The second one is 30 to 50% savings is total drug discovery and development cost. So what happens is only the 30 to 50% of the money we need to spend on the research and development. Otherwise, rest of the things are profit. So if India can bring a very big platform for a R&D, we can challenge anybody in the world in the pharma front is concerned. We are good in medicine from the Chinese, very, very time immemorial. Our ancient traditional medicines we got from Aryabhata and others who gave wonderful medicine. We have been imbibed from that ancient traditional practices of getting a medicines. We are also, our brains are like that. Our Indian brains are wonderful. Still, we are onto the path of getting a very good researched medicines. Next. The spread of generics and increasing outsourcing. Now the generic, most of the generic is which is manufactured in India has a potential to manufacture being outsourced. So there we lose enormous, what you call, income generation for the purpose. Next. Okay. Never vacancies and diagnostic kits. Next. Development in biotechnology and molecular biology, we are very good in that. Definitely we can contribute much to the much bigger level to us. So middle class population and rising urbanization will definitely need a lot of medicines to be supplied to our people, and it is increasing, the awareness is increasing. Next, the liberalization, ample export opportunity we have, we can able to earn huge money out of it, where our Karnataka antibiotics also earning good money out of that exports, besides catering to the local needs. Next, the lowest cost of production, especially in India, due to lowest cost, the people are buying most of the medicine from us. Okay, labor massive compare, I have just pointed out already. Next. India's health awareness is increased manifold. Potential local and international markets availability and required quality is improved. Okay, manpower is young. So most of our population is 60% of our population are younger population. We have a very beautiful brain drain. The younger population compared to the America, other countries in the world, they are about crashed more than 80s. They are worthless. The population is worthless. Whereas India's population is youngest population. We can tap the real potential and source. And we can really grow, like there is a huge potential to grow in this pharma segment. Okay, next. This is about India. Next. So different product life cycles. Next, please. Okay, domestic consumption is per capita GDP expected to quadruple, because the gross domestic product which we have, we definitely we can crash more than four times. We have around 60% of GDP comes out of these pharma companies, where we can increase it to the fourfold. I am sure about the pharma company can do like that. Okay, next points. Global presence, India present in pharma segment in almost all the countries in the world. We have such a wonderful superpower, and we have brain. We have such a wonderful brain with us to sell our products in the world countries. Okay, the branded generic drugs, multi-country operations, we have almost all the pharma companies are operating throughout the world, not only in India. Our products have been purchased throughout the world. Okay, next. Okay, Vision 2020, reserve brain drain, new drug discovery is part of the world done. Okay, apart from this, I just want a few minutes, sir, with your permission. Our Karnataka Antibiotics is one of the very prime company, where it has been started by Aati Committee report. On 1981, it has started. It has grown with a 10 crore company. The promoters are relation with our promoters are HAL Hindustan Antibiotics Limited, and now it has been delinked. The Karnataka Antibiotics is delinked from HAL Hindustan Antibiotics Limited, Pimpri, Pune, and we are able to enter MOU, Memorandum of Understanding, with directly with the government, and we are very sufficient. We could able to achieve anything, any big things in the field of pharma and in medicines. So this is about the India as a whole in the pharma sector, and our Karnataka Antibiotics is a continuous profit-making organization which made around 20 crores profit every year without fail. Being a, such a company, catering the needs for the life of the citizens, where they say disinvest. A small company, they want to disinvest. I just want to keep my humble request to our senior leaders here. See that it should not happen, and the Niti has already recommended Karnataka Antibiotics also to be privatized or disinvested. Thank you for this opportunity for the senior leaders and the commoders, all the commoders here. Thank you, sir.
Request comrade Ashok Selalkar from MDL.
Dear comrades, introduce
it, sir.